More bad news for the Russian invading forces currently attempting to wipe out virtually every civilian inside of Ukraine. There's more updated reports that some soldiers on the Russian side are purposefully destroying their own equipment so that they don't have to engage with the Ukrainian forces with them. So in one regiment, and this is being reported on by the Daily Beast, one Russian soldier allegedly said that they'd been pouring sand into the fuel system of their tank to clog them up and make them unable to actually work, saying, "I don't follow stupid orders, I simply refuse. The mother effers sent me to tanks, mother effing piece of S, I effed it up and that's it." I'm assuming that that translates cleanly over. Maybe something is lost in the translation, but
mother effing
anyway.
Piece of S needs to be a dragon name. Mother effing piece of S. Just a
mother
good
effing
dragon
piece
name.
Of S dragon.
I know we have another mother effing dragon, but mother effing piece of S.
Mm-hmm. Let's see if we can get a clogged fuel system dragon. Anyway, the Russian soldier that he was talking to on the line, he was communicating with another soldier, apparently heard that the unit wasn't punished for doing that, which seems to indicate that their commanding officers know that they're doing this. And anyway, he said that, yeah, no, maybe I'll do that with mine. Another Russian fighter shared with a family member that he and his comrades deliberately damaged their tank, which was at that point the last one in their regiment, so that their attack plan wouldn't be able to go forward, saying, "We have one tank left in the regiment. In short, we broke our tank ourselves in the morning so as not to go." It's like calling in sick, but mid-invasion, Francesca.
I mean, yeah, it reminds me of what happened during Vietnam, right? The Vietnam War, where US soldiers, I think it was called fragging, is what it was when you basically like hazed your own general and your own officer by like locking him in his tent or like pouring some water on him or just like, you know, yeah, I mean, I'm not locking him in his car, but essentially like disobeying orders, like, I made the Vietnam War like an 80s film, a John Waters film. But anyway, it was.
I believe the origin of the term is literally killing them with a grenade, so there's some plausible deniability.
Okay,
maybe there was basically some a mutiny
death.
Where you murder
maybe.
Your officer. But sure, maybe. Locking him in the car and you know, putting cellophane over the toilet so he gets pee on his pants.
Yeah,
same
exactly.
thing, really.
Putting his hand in warm water, all that.
Oh, they hate that.
But again, this is what happens when soldiers know they've been conscripted and enlisted to die in an unjust war that has no point, that is dragging on forever and ever. They see themselves being the bad guys in the we are baddies moment. And I guess the perks of getting to rape and pillage just don't really hit in the same way as they used to, considering once you kill people, they're no longer there. So good on these Russian soldiers. Again, Putin's been treating them like fodder. He's been treating his own civilians that way. He doesn't care, and suppressing any kind of dissent inside the country. So this is a natural conclusion. It's incredible to me that you would rather risk being punished by Russia, by Russian, you know, officers yourself. Then sort of march into certain death. And it also shows that potentially, you know, Ukraine might be getting the upper hand.
Yeah, well, we'll see. Reports like this have been coming out from fairly early on. You can see this is a little headline for back March 31st. So we're talking like 5 weeks ago. So this has been like occurring throughout. And it's not like they can afford to be having tanks like out of service because they're pouring sugar in the tank. Like they've lost, I believe, more than 500 tanks at this point, which is just to imagine that a military has 500 tanks is crazy, but that's how many they lost of their tanks, let alone any number of other aircraft, armored vehicles, and those sorts of things. One apparently shot down their own aircraft at some point. They've sabotaged other equipment. I wouldn't be surprised if they were sabotaging radio equipment so as to not receive orders that they don't want to then follow. They're also putting out information about, for instance, the comparison of their equipment. So we know that early on there was comparisons of the rations that were being sent into war in comparison to what the Ukrainians were eating. But there you see a comparison of the first aid kits. And look, there was an amazing breakdown that I read of one of the reasons why they're losing so many tanks and so many tank crews is there are different ways that you can structure the inside of a tank. And basically, I don't know what the benefits to the way the Russians do it is, but the consequence is that the ammunition is effectively stored in the same area where the crew of the tank are stored. So if you pierce into the crew compartment, the ammunition cooks off, it explodes and kills the crew. Whereas in Western tanks, it's a separate section that's walled off. Oh yeah, so now I remember. It's a little bit faster to reload when the ammunition is right there. If you have to open up a special hatch, that's like pressure sealed, that's slower. but you don't necessarily lose the crew. And that's important because crews are harder to replace than tanks, assuming that you care about the fundamental humanity of your soldiers, even sort of a minimal amount. And the
indisputable good old capitalism. Capitalism won the Cold War.
Exactly.
I mean, there you go, right there.
Yeah.
Better so anyway, tanks.
It's always been clear that, you know, they don't care as much about their soldiers. And certainly there's a lot of that to go around in every military around the world, but it's seemingly worse for the Russians. And as they prepare to like do this big mobilization of more people who are going to be even less excited to be involved in this war, now going into a war where they've already lost tons of people. These initial soldiers came in thinking that they had this thing locked down. Now you're going to be having people conscripted, sent into a war that they're going to be getting more and more information is not going well. We could see a rise in sabotage coming from that.
Yeah, I mean, this is the last thing I'll say is you can tell the people back home whatever you want to tell them, but the people who are really going to spread that message are the soldiers themselves who are coming back maimed and traumatized, and also understanding more than anyone. Again, just like we heard stories from our failed occupations of Afghanistan and Iraq, that it was like the soldiers would come back from the front line being like, I don't know what we're still doing there. Honestly, yeah. What is the mission anymore? And that is gonna spread more so than, you know, than Putin's propaganda.